kans af, de deadline. En dan moeten Europa en Griekenland eruit zijn. De euroministers van Financiën die buigen zich nu over voorstellen. Hun oordeel is essentieel voor de kans op succes morgen. Het Griekse parlement steunt nu de bezuinigingsvoorstellen waar het Griekse volk vorige week zondag nog nee tegen zei. Durven de Europese regeringsleiders hun parlementen te vragen opnieuw miljarden aan Griekenland te lenen? De Eurogroep zit nog steeds bij elkaar om te praten over de Griekse bezuinigingsvoorstellen.
En die gesprekken daarover zouden moeizaam verlopen. Veel landen eisen meer van de Grieken. De gesprekken vinden zoals altijd plaats achter gesloten deuren. Vanmiddag, net voordat de ministers naar binnen gingen, hoorden we ze voor het laatst.
Nu Griekenland en de rest van Europa al zo lang lijnrecht tegenover elkaar staan, is er iemand nodig die de partijen met elkaar verbindt, vindt Frankrijk.
En we spelen deze rol van trait d'union jusqu'au bout. Pour apporter notre contribution à une réussite qui est indispensable à tous.
En dus is de Franse minister van Financiën binnen het oliemannetje dat zich niet negatief uitlaat over de nieuwe Griekse voorstellen.
C'était une bonne base pour engager des discussions et des négociations.
Maar dan de andere ministers.
Het ziet er toch nog wel tamelijk ingewikkeld uit, zowel op de inhoud als op het soms nog veel lastiger vraagstuk van vertrouwen.
This package would be appropriate for the completion of the second program, but I'm afraid this is not enough for the third program, for the ESM program.
Wir werden außergewöhnlich schwierige Verhandlungen haben.
Over het geschonden Europese vertrouwen al net zulke verschillende geluiden. Frankrijk wijt dat niet aan de huidige Griekse regering.
Mais qui est une confiance abîmée par rapport à tous les gouvernements grecs depuis des années et des années.
Ook daar denkt de rest anders over.
We hebben natuurlijk ook de situatie dat ze alles gedaan hebben om dat wat men ownership noemt, namelijk het verlassen daarop dat ze doen wat ze versprechen, niet gerade te sterken.
We're discussing a proposal from the Greek government that was fiercely rejected less than a week ago, and that is a serious concern.
En dus heeft de Franse minister zich als zelfbenoemd bemiddelaar een moeilijke taak op de hals gehaald.
We gaan naar Brussel. Arjan Noorlander is daar. Arjan, ja, al 7 uur in overleg. Welke geluiden vang jij op? Wat gebeurt daar binnen?
Het Griekse parlement heeft vannacht ingestemd met de voorstellen die de regering naar Brussel heeft gestuurd. En we zeiden het al, het is zeer opmerkelijk, want nog maar een week geleden op zondag stemde de Griekse bevolking in grote meerderheid precies tegen al deze voorstellen tijdens het referendum. Kijkt u mee.
Tsipras Alexios. Nee.
Het was een zware avond voor de Griekse premier. Hij moest steun zoeken voor zijn bezuinigingsvoorstellen en zich ervoor verantwoorden.
Προχωρήσαμε όσο περισσότερο μπορούσε να φανταστεί κανείς ότι θα μπορούσαμε να προχωρήσουμε. Τώρα όμως έχω την αίσθηση ότι φτάσαμε στη διακεκαυμένη ζώνη.
Maar nu met zo'n andere boodschap in het parlement komen dan de afgelopen tijd, het blijkt voor een aantal parlementsleden een brug te ver.
Περιεχόμενο της συμφωνίας δεν θα μπορούσα ποτέ να το ψηφίσω και να το νομιμοποιήσω. Το ίδιο πιστεύω ότι ισχύει και θα ίσχυε για τον Πρωθυπουργό που σήμερα εκβιάζεται με όπλο την επιβίωση αυτού του λαού.
Κύριε. Στο ερώτημα αν κάναμε λάθη στη διάρκεια της πεντάμινης διαπραγμάτευσης, η μόνη ειλικρινής απάντηση είναι η καταφατική. Ναι, κάναμε λάθη.
Έκανε αυτό που λέμε κολοτούμπα και μεγάλη κολοτούμπα έκανε.
Είναι ένα τεράστιο φορτίο αυτό το νέο πρόγραμμα και ειδικά πλήττει τους συνταξιούχους ιδίως και άλλες κατηγορίες.
Προχωρούμε, παρακαλώ πολύ. Εψήφισαν 251 βουλευτές. Όχι, εψήφισαν 32 βουλευτές.
Θα καταφέρουμε όχι μόνο να μείνουμε στην Ευρώπη, αλλά να ζήσουμε ως ισότιμος εταίρος, με αξιοπρέπεια και περηφάνεια, διεκδικώντας το δίκαιο μας στην Ευρώπη, ανοίγοντας δρόμους για τους υπόλοιπους λαούς της Ευρώπης. Σας ευχαριστώ.
Dan gaan we naar Kreta. Daar is Yannis Koutsoumitis. Hij is Grieks politiek analist. En we voeren dit gesprek live. U zult in de ondertiteling misschien af en toe zien dat het niet helemaal precies vertaald wordt. Mr. Koutsoumitis, good evening. Can you hear me?
Good evening. Good evening to you.
Yes. First of all, Mr. Koutsoumitis, what we hear from Brussels is that it's not going too well. It seems that the ministers of finance are not really satisfied with the Greek proposal. Are you worried?
I am worried because we hear that there will be additional measures to be asked by the Greek government. And also there is the problem with the Finnish government that has a limited mandate from the governing parties for a deal with Greece. Also there is the political risk in the Greek government, since last night there were no votes and abstentions from the governing coalition MPs. So Mr. Tsipras tomorrow will be asked to prove if he's able, if he has the necessary governing majority to implement any deal that will be agreed by the Eurogroup.
Well, but it looks like there will be no deal tomorrow.
Yes, but my understanding is there might be the Eurogroup might ask for prior actions from the Greek government to implement and legislate before there will be an additional, a new Eurogroup that will decide whether then there can be any agreement.
What do you make of the German proposal that basically suggests that Greece should have a holiday of 5 years outside the euro?
I think this is it will not work. It will not work because if Greece is either forced out of the Eurozone or decides on its own to leave, there is no practical way to keep Greece for 5 years in, let's say, a suspended status. I don't think the Greek political system or the financial system will be at this position to maintain such plan for 5 years. So I don't think it will work. We are in a position right now which will either Greece stays in the Eurozone with very strict conditions or it leaves outright.
Now, you had the referendum exactly almost a week ago on Sunday. People were then voting against all these proposals that are now in this Greek plan. How is it even possible that there is now a majority for this plan, which says exactly the opposite of last Sunday?
Yes, well, the vast majority of the people who voted yes are in favor of closing a deal. And a much, I don't know if it's a majority, but big number of the people who voted no want an agreement, but wanted another round of negotiations. Mr. Tsipras explained yesterday that a new round of negotiations is not possible. We have reached a minefield right now, and the Greek government needs to compromise and become very, very accommodative to the demands that the Eurogroup will ask.
So the deal that is now on the table is even worse than the one we had?
Yes, of course, because in the last 2 weeks, the situation fiscally and economically has worsened a lot. There are some indications that there are about 3.5 to 4 billion euros of damage being done to the economy. So definitely there will be additional measures asked, and also the big question how the Greek banking system will be able to be recapitalized again and work again under Eurozone conditions.
So could you say, Mr. Koutsoumitis, that this referendum by Tsipras was the dumbest thing he ever did in his life?
I think it was one of the dumbest political decisions ever taken by a Greek government.
What do you expect if there will be a Grexit? We talked before about this issue. How will your country look like on Monday or Tuesday next week?
Well, it depends on how the European Commission will accommodate some reasonable situation regarding the banks, common life, and humanitarian aid. If Greece is left out in the wild, I think it will be a very, very difficult situation. But I hope and I believe that the European Union, whatever the outcome, will stand by Greece and support it in any way it can.
Mr. Koutsoumitis, please stay with us because we have news from our correspondent in Brussels, Arjen Noorlander. Ja, Arjan, daar ben je. Wat is het laatste nieuws vanuit Brussel? Mr. Koutsoumitis. So the latest news we heard from our correspondent is that there maybe will be more time decided by the Eurogroup to give the Greek government more time to get to the austerity measures that are needed. Do you need more time?
Well, I think politically more time is needed because Mr. Tsipras needs to gather a new coalition. this his coalition with many of the MPs, around 32 MPs, are not willing to vote for austerity measures and reforms. So Mr. Tsipras has, as soon as possible, and I think talks are already underway, to form a new coalition government, probably a wider grand coalition with more opposition parties, in order to have enough votes to implement the necessary reforms.
Very clear. Yanis Koutsoumitis in Greece, thank you so much for your time tonight.
Thank you for having me.